Okay, so DOCX to PDF, pip install, and I'm just going to install it on my Windows machine here. Pip install DOCX to PDF. And that should work fairly quickly. Get a few warning messages. It's safe to ignore those. I don't tend to use Windows as my main operating system, so apologies for that. Let's try again using --user. And it says it's already installed. Okay, let's just wait and see what happens here. I've just read that you need to use --user, and I think that's worked. Let's just test it. So CLS clear screen, Python. I think that should give me throughput. Yes, it does, 3.92. And let's just see what the documentation says so we can test it. So from DOCX to PDF, import convert. And we don't get an error, so we know that that's successfully installed. So that's part one, how to install DOCX to PDF. Right, part two, let's look at the code. So the first thing you want to do is actually, assuming we've already installed it using pip install or conda or homebrew or whatever, then we want to just do from DOCX to PDF. Import convert. I hope that font's big enough. Let me just zoom in. Is that better? Hope so. And also we will import OS because we're going to be working with listing the files in a directory because we want to list the Word documents which we want to convert to PDF. So we'll also import glob. Glob searches for, I think that's, is it grep large objects? I don't know, but it searches for files with a specific mask, wildcard mask, like you would with grep. So then next, what we want to do is we want to say something like current underscore dir equals, and then we'll run os.get CWD and we'll get the current directory. So let's just run that. That's okay, that's good. No errors there. And then we want to just put a comment. Source directory for the doc. Source for the docx. Actually source directory. The docx files are the source, and then the path to those is equal to, we want to do os.listdir, and then that will list all of the docx files in current directory. Missed an equals there. Right, so let's just, if we do print path after that, we'll see what we've got. Just run that. I've actually created three test files in this current directory. So, what it's actually doing is it's finding all of the files. So as you can see, I've got some MKV video recordings in there. I've got some Jupyter Notebook files in there and everything. So in order to filter those out, what we will need to do is we'll actually need to filter those when we run our for loop that does the file conversions. So here we'll say for docx files in, and then within the path, so the path is all of these. We say if docx files, and then we're going to look at the, we'll go from the right hand end of each of those items in the list, because this is a Python list, because you've got the square brackets, and we want to be finding the ones where we've got full stop, and then, so that's actually five characters. We've got full stop, DOCX. So we want to go from the end back to, we want to go minus five. And then we want the colon. So that's basically going from the right hand end, and it's working back five, and it's checking if those five characters are equal, double equals to full stop DOCX. I mean, obviously, if you were working with, if it was in the old days, it would just be dot DOC, so then you'd be doing minus four instead of minus five. And with this import, so we've already imported convert, so we're using the convert method, and then we're just going to say convert the docx files. So for every docx file that it finds in that path, it's going to convert it to a PDF. And then I'm not going to demonstrate it yet, because what we want to do is we want to filter out the PDF files afterwards. So if we create a variable called PDFs equal to, now what we need to do is PDFs equals glob.glob. So glob is the import, but it's also got a glob method. And then we want to just look for, keep the single quotes, we want to look for star.pdf, and that's going to create a variable, and then we just want to print the variable to see actually what we've achieved with our conversion. So if we just do print PDFs, and if I just call up the folder where I've got all of my source documents, I'm just going to do that off screen. I'm going to go and I've had one test attempt at this already, little disclaimer, and let's run this. So I'm just going to get rid of the header and the toolbar. That's it. Header, toolbar, no header, no toolbar, that's better. In fact, let's go the whole way. Let's make it really neat. So when I run it this time, in here, you shouldn't see any PDF files, because I've just deleted those. So in fact, if I run this step by step, I think that's probably a good thing to do. So if I just run this cell, control and enter, isn't it? And there we see there are no PDF files in this directory. In fact, if you want to see it, I'm just going to drag the window across. So I've got a load of videos, because where I'm recording with OBS, it's actually putting my video files in the same directory. So that's Python code runner. So there's no PDFs as yet. In fact, if I just make this a bit smaller, so hopefully you'll see the progress as it runs through. If I park that down there. So then we're going to run, it won't do what I, in Linux you can do keep on top. Anyway, for doc files in the path, so it's going to find 1, 2, 3. If you want to see those files, I'm just going to open one. So that's my abracadabra file. Then one called Timbuktu and one called Mofo. So three Word documents. And if I run this, I have invalid syntax. Well, what's gone wrong there? Oh, the colon. Right, let's run it again. And something's happening. We've got progress bar. So, and as you can see, the PDFs have been created. So what the difference between this video and my previous one, sorry, the camera's dropped, isn't it? Sorry about that. in the previous video, I was enumerating the files and I was just creating the files and giving them a sequential numeric name prefix. So it was 1.pdf, 2.pdf, and so on. So the difference on this video, as per the subscriber's request, was to actually, let's just run this, was to actually give the files the same name. So if you've got a Word document called Letter to Santa .docx, then the PDF will be called Letter to Santa .pdf. And there we go. So that's just set the variable. And if I run that, there we see. So I've ended up with three PDF files, and the three PDF files have the same name as the DOCX files that I began with. So hopefully that's cleared that up. And really, the code is very straightforward. It's really the only things to get your head around on this, if you've not come across it before, is glob. So glob.glob, and that's, I think it's grep large objects, may be wrong. But then you just put a wildcard, so you don't care about the prefix, but you do care about the file extension, so you just put .pdf and so on. And I've done this in Jupyter Notebook, and it looks quite nice, and it's probably just really clear to understand. And there we go. So thank you for watching. Hopefully that's cleared that up. If there's any questions, then drop me a line. Otherwise, I'll see you in the next video. And thumbs up and all that. So thanks for watching.